So, hello everyone. It's Tuesday evening again, and the presentation of nations are calling. And today you'll be able to see one of the last ones, and that's the presentation of Netherlands. But before the presentation itself starts, let me tell you traditionally some intro about the upcoming events from the ESN. So tomorrow, the final quiz night will take place, and this one will be the last of this semester. And there will be also the announcement of the results and giving the prizes to the winners. But don't be sad if you are not currently leading, because tomorrow there will be more points for correct answers. So even if you are currently not in the top places, maybe you can manage it tomorrow and get to the top and win something. Also on Thursday there will be an Instagram stream called Act Green. And on this stream, there will be two guests, and those are the docent Professor Jiří Zach from the Faculty of Civil Engineering. And the second one is the Erasmus student Dimitri Ionescu, who is the winner of the French Student Entrepreneur Grand Prize of 2019 and the finalist for Climate Launch 2020. And they will talk about ecology and its implementation in civil engineering and architecture. Also next week, there will be the last presentation of nations, since it's the last week of the semester. And it will be, again, a very exotic country, because we'll be talking about the country of Sri Lanka. And also the next day, on Wednesday, there will be the result announcement of the presentation of nations, because yeah, everyone from ESN is looking to these presentations, and we are giving points. So yeah, the best presentations of the semester will definitely win some prizes. Also, I would like to remind you of our origami event. So you can still throw some origami pieces to the box near the Panda Point for the local BRNO charity. And the last thing I want to talk about is the challenge number one, which is called Let's Improve Our Role From Now. And you'll be able to see more information about this thing and also the other events on our Facebook group. And now let me give the word to the speaker for Netherlands, Michelle.
Good afternoon. I'm Michiel, or Michael, because that's easier for you. And today I will present my country, the Netherlands, to you. We're located in the western part of Europe. You should be able to see it on the next slide. We tend to say we're pretty centralized Europe, but apparently we're really western, especially with the UK leaving Europe. And we're just a really small country. And because we're so small, people don't know that much about us. So they make one really common mistake, and that's the mistake that they tend to say that I speak Deutsch or am Deutsch. But this is the thing, please don't do it wrong after this. Deutsch is saying German, an actual German language, and I'm Dutch. That's my language in English. And my nationality is also Dutch, but I live in the Netherlands. Kind of complicated, but now you should be able to know it, so please don't say Deutsch anymore. Our little country, if you zoom it in, then there's one really special thing about us, and that's that most of our country is actually below sea level. That's why we're so famous about our waters, but also why we have so many troubles with waters. As you can see on this slide, with the map on the left side, all the colored regions were actually sea before, and we actually made land from the sea. And we also created, you can see it maybe a small, on top of the red zone, there's a line, and that's one big wall we actually built inside of the sea to protect us from the sea and create a huge lake called the Afsluit Dijk. And it also features a highway to connect the Netherlands better. Speaking of our country, I actually kind of lied to you that I'm from the Netherlands, because I'm actually from the Kingdom of Netherlands. We have still quite some islands next to South America, so not close to us at all. So we are a kingdom, and that's why we also have a king. His full name is Willem Alexander Klaus George Ferdinand van Oranje-Nassau. A shit ton of words. We just like to call him Willem Alexander, his first name. And he's famous for quite some things. Like, he doesn't have any real use, but he's only about talking with different countries. And that's why we kind of like to make fun of him, because he doesn't do that much. So, for example, he's known to be called Prince Pils, which is Prince Pilsner, because he really likes to drink a lot of beers. But apart from that, he's also been doing pretty good in terms of sports. We have got this ice skating challenge called the Elfstedentocht, which is the route of 11 cities. It's a 200 kilometers ice skating route through the northern parts of the Netherlands. And the guy in the red jacket is actually our current king. He finished it years ago when he was still young. And of course, we're quite known for ice skating. That's the only thing we're good at during the Olympic Games. But we are quite good at it. Also, our king actually got his own flying license, so he's allowed to fly. And he also tends to fly his own royal plane and also charter flights for KLM Air France to get his flight hours. And of course, on the left side, in his flying, in his pilot suit, but still with a nice beer in his hand. Next to that, the Dutch people are really famous for orange. Why do we have all this orange? And that's because, like you could have seen in his name, the last part of his surname is Van Oranje-Nassau, which is from orange, as they got a small village back in the day in France, in southern France. They got it somehow, our first king, and that's why we have this whole orange fever now. Like, our football team is orange. On King's Day, which is the birthday of our king, we're all in orange, and everything is always orange. Like you could have seen on the first picture in orange, there's the canals from Amsterdam. So now I'm going to talk a bit about our cities and what you can see in the Netherlands if you actually go there once. So first, Amsterdam. Of course, known as it is our capital, with a lot of canals, but it's mainly known for drugs and prostitution, and we kind of have some red lights in some streets. But apart from that, I think it's a really nice city. The vibe is good. It's pretty safe, so it's nice to be there. And in case you are there, it's pretty easy to go to the Keukenhof, which is basically a huge garden filled with tulips and arts of tulips, really famous amongst mainly Asian people. And it's pretty close. Actually, everything is close because we're such a small country. And also Kinderdijk is the place where you can see many windmills along dikes in the Dutch surroundings. So really nice to go there. If you're in Amsterdam, you can visit those places from there. And other cities, Utrecht. It basically has all the features of Amsterdam. We've got the canals, we've got the weed, and everything you want, but it's a lot smaller, so less tourists and a bit calmed down. I really like the city, and it also features the largest bicycle parking in the world, with I think 4 or 5 stories of bicycle parking. If we stay in the same region, we have got Rotterdam. Also pretty famous. It's a really modern city, as the Germans actually bombed it in the Second World War. As we had some, they told us they would bomb us if we don't surrender. We surrendered, but in the time, the deadline, in a different time zone. So we were already too late, because Germany back then had a different time zone. So they bombed it all, which is of course not a good thing. But now it's a really modern city with modern architecture and really good infrastructure. So in the end, also some good things from that. Still in the same region, because all of our big cities are actually in the same region, with Den Haag, or in English, The Hague. It's our political city. On the left photo, you can actually see where our minister does always like private and important talks. And on the right side, you can see a really famous hotel at Kurhaus, which is also a casino. Really fun to go there, and it's next to the seaside, so you can go there. And also, the International Court of Justice is in The Hague, so if you really mess up, you might actually go to The Hague, not for fun. We go up north in the Netherlands. We go to Groningen, which is also a town with a lot of water. It's known for one of the most intense student associations, with a lot of rumors about people dying in introduction weeks. But apart from that, it's actually a really nice city. It's the most well-known student city in the Netherlands. We tend to think it's far away, but for the people, it might be close. It's just 3 hours by train, and then it costs like half of our country. So that's how small it is. And then if we totally go down south instead of north, we go to Maastricht. And Maastricht is really known for their ambience. We tend to call it gezelligheid. And gezelligheid means like outgoing, nice, social, warm feeling. And you can really see that in the Christmas markets or with Carnival, which we mainly do in the southern parts. And gezellig is actually kind of known because it doesn't have a translation in any other language except for it makes sense in Dutch. And therefore, when President Barack Obama visited the Netherlands, he actually tried to speak some Dutch, and there you can see that our G and R's are really hard to pronounce, just like in Michiel, my name, or gezellig, or regenen, which is to rain, is really difficult, so you can see it in the next video.
I'm told there's a Dutch word that captures the spirit, which doesn't translate exactly into English, but let me say that my first visit to the Netherlands has been truly gezellig.
So actually you did a relatively good job, but still really hard. And also this southern region is for us known for its mountainous terrain. And the Netherlands is pretty flat, so our highest part on our European part is the Vaalsberg with a mere 322 meters. But we actually do have our mountain since we are the kingdom. We also have got the islands. So we got one mountain, which is higher than 750 meters, the official limit for a mountain. And should be able to see it in the next video of the map. It's not really anywhere close to our mainland, but still it's part of our land. So we do have one mountain, in case you were wondering. Next up, I want to talk about personal traits of Dutch people. What are we like, and how do we react? First, one of our traits, people tend to call me tall. I'm not that tall for Dutch people, actually. Our average is 183 centimeters for males and 170 for females, which makes us the tallest nation in the world. And also, we're kind of known to be really careful about our money. We're even known if we go to Turkey, they say kijken, kijken, niet kopen, which means to look, be really interested, and in the end, you don't buy the stuff on the market. And also in English, mainly used in Ireland, it's a saying to go Dutch in a restaurant, and that's actually to split the bill to go Dutch. We're also known for being really direct. We just say what we want to say, and we're trying to be as honest as we can. So also, if you just ask me, how are you doing? I won't just react with, yeah, I'm good. And what about you? But I will just honestly say, like, maybe how my day was. And if it was bad, I will just tell you it was bad. Because why would I ask if you don't give me the real answer? I'm just direct. I wouldn't ask if I don't actually care about how you're doing. And next, we have dinner at 6 o'clock, which is amazingly early for, especially, I think, Spanish and French people. But for us, between 5 and 6 is just normal times. Next up, it's our birthday parties. Somehow, we always manage to get kind of awkward birthday parties. We call them kringverjaardag, which is like a circle of the people, which you can see in the picture. You cannot cross the middle, and you try to talk with some people, but they're always on the other side. So it doesn't work, but it's how we do it, and we will never change. We get with each other 3 kisses, only women and women and men and women do that in family gatherings, never man and man. That's really weird to us. And we somehow congratulate everyone on the birthday party. So in case it's your birthday, I will walk up to your mom saying happy birthday with your daughter. Your mom will say happy birthday with your friend. I will walk up to your aunt and she will do the same. And you'll pass the whole circle saying happy birthday because you survived another year or something. Doesn't make sense, but that's how we do it. Next to that, we are pretty open-minded on multiple levels. For example, gay marriage was first legal in the Netherlands. So we also have a really huge gay pride, which is also on the canals and includes quite some orange too. We're known for our weed, of course. Weed is practically legal in the Netherlands, not fully, but you can see it as legal. And because it is legal, we can just like walk to a coffee shop, just like buying a normal coffee, actually, and you just have a menu. You can just choose, like, I want that type, that many grams. And you can actually sit down in the coffee shop and just roll and enjoy your joint. No problem at all. We're pretty open in terms of abortion, especially in Poland. That's changing right now, of course, but we're really open to that. And we also got quite open-minded laws about euthanasia. So in the Netherlands, if it's known that you won't survive your health problems or something, you can actually say to the doctor that you want him to take your life. And that's under certain conditions, of course, and that's fully legal, which I think is only legal in Belgium, Luxembourg, and the Netherlands. And then, of course, bikes. Like, we've got our weed, but we also got our bikes. And I saw it already in the Zen chat, somebody being like, yeah, I would love to hear you say that we have more bikes than people, and we actually do. On average, we got 1.3 bikes per people. And I think at some point I got 4 bikes myself. And we got pretty strange things. On the left side, you can see a whole boat. It's an old ferry. And it's located behind Amsterdam Central Station. And it's only for bikes. And on this slide, you can just, for us, it's a really normal situation. On the left side, I was taking my oven I just bought home, taking on the bike. If you pick up your kids from school, oh, I also have to do grocery shopping. No problem at all. That's really normal to us. We cycle everywhere. And I think this was when Obama came over. This was the biggest difference. He had like 4 helicopters. And our prime minister just cycles to work every day, even if it's raining. He doesn't care. And since we're so into bikes, we also got some pretty intense innovations on bikes. So on the left side, you can actually see a heated bicycle path to make the snow melt so it's not slippery. And on the right side, it says Fietsnelweg, which is bicycle highway, which is a bike lane without any traffic lights, so you can go quicker from A to B between cities. And of course, if you've got a lot of bikes, especially after some drinks, and you've got the canals too, might go wrong at some point, so they actually have like full-time jobs to fish out the bikes from the canals. Speaking of drinks, I think everyone should know Heineken, the beer. I've seen Bavaria actually over here too, and I just want to give you one advice. Don't buy it. It sucks. I hate it. We're not proud of Heineken at all. They drink it everywhere. We don't understand. So what I recommend, if you're ever in the Netherlands, try this beer. It's called Hertog Jan. Probably hard to pronounce, but just find the golden label. And we actually got quite some things we like to say during drinking beer. We tend to refer to the beer as an goudgele pretcylinder, which means a yellow gold fun cylinder. as the beer is, of course, like a yellow goldish color, and it gives you fun in a cylinder. To say cheers, we tend to say Prost. It's really close to German, but that's like a shorter O. And two sayings you might hear me say in a pub if I meet you. Klinken is drinken. Klinken is the word for cheersing, the sound of cheersing, and is drinken is to drink. So every time you cheers, you also have to drink a sip. And the last one is it's a pretty rough one. It says, twee in de hand is één achter de tand, which is if you have two drinks in your hand, you have to chug one to get it behind your jaw. So make sure you never have two drinks if you're in the same pub as I am, because I make you drink those. To go along the drinks, we also have food, of course. The most typical main dish is stamppot, which is a group name of basically cooked vegetables with cooked mashed potatoes. And the two most famous ones on the left-hand side, it's hutspot. It's cooked carrots and onions combined with mashed potatoes. And on the right side, it's boerenkool. It's a kind of cabbage with also the mashed potatoes. And we always eat them with a smoked sausage and a rookwurst. And we only eat rookwurst with stamppot, basically. And talking about food, we're somehow actually the biggest food exporter behind the United States, even though we're such a small country. More food, if you take a look at street food, we quite eat a lot of fish. On the left side, it's herring. We eat them raw with onions, and you actually have to eat them like that. It gives some pretty fun sights to see people eating a herring on the streets like that. And also kibbling, it's kind of like fish and chips. It's white fish with a batter and then fried. But it's a bit different. There are smaller pieces and more crunchy. And then we've got like, we call them bull snacks. We really like to deep fry, especially when you have, we call the bubble, which is like to come together. It can either be like a formal or informal, just to have some drinks after work. And we really like to fry at that point. So on the left side, it's the most famous one. It's in bitterball. It's like a goulash with a crunchy outside. In the middle, we've got the frikandel, which is also a meaty thing. And on the right side, it's in gasafe, which is basically like a cheese pocket. And if you ever happen to have like an internship or work in the Netherlands, always go to the Vrijmibo, which stands for Vrijdagmiddagborrel, which is Friday afternoon borrel, which is to come together and discuss your week with your colleagues and enjoy a beer. So definitely go there to get to know your colleagues a bit better. It's a great opportunity, I think. And then cookies. The stroopwafel is a caramel waffle in English. It's pretty famous. We really like it, especially when it's fresh. And it's just a little sugar, so that's always good. And lastly, this is a really seasonal cookie. It's called pepernoten. I actually have them laying next to me. It's for St. Nicholas. And we actually tend to put these sweets inside of our shoe and put it up front at the fireplace in our house. And that's all about our cultural thing with St. Nicholas. We tend to say that this guy actually comes from Spain by boat every year to bring gifts to children. And alongside, he has his helpers. And this is why it's getting more and more known out of racism, as his helpers happen to be black, have really big red lips, golden earrings, which refer to slavery, and the list goes on and on. But for us, the main part is we have a really nice party, basically, where you get like gifts and older people write poems, and we have the typical sweets. And we say that somehow the guy goes up with the horse on your roof, and through the chimney they bring the gifts, and that's why they're kind of black somehow. But also that's how we put our shoe up front of the fireplace, because the snacks will come through the chimney inside of your shoe. After this, I would like to speak a bit about music. Martin Garrix, you should know him. He's actually Dutch. We tend to call him Martijn Gerritsen. And I think this will be one of his most famous songs. The second artist, also pretty well known, is Armin van Buuren, also a Dutch guy, and I think he's even like 40 years old now. And I think you should know this song too. It's quite an old one, but still really rememberable. The last songs have both been English spoken ones, and this is one of the few songs that's actually quite popular, I think, even outside the Netherlands, which is a Dutch one. It's also translated into German, which would make Stoff und Schnaps, but this is Drank en Drugs, and it basically says, like, one guy who will, don't worry about it, I'll bring the drugs, and every youth says yes to taking acid. And it's crazy popular in the Netherlands, so let's listen to it for a bit. As you might have figured out by now, we're quite into like party music and DJs. And it actually showed off because in 2018, the top DJ list was basically only Dutch guys. The names in bold and italics are all Dutch guys. So you have Martin Garrix, Hardwell, Armin van Buuren, Chester, Don Diablo, Afrojack, and even Oliver Heldens. They're all Dutch guys. So yeah, we're pretty good at that, apparently. And other things we would like to say we're good at is, well, football isn't going too well for the last years, but before we were pretty okay with the Flying Dutchman, Robin van Persie, making goal, I think it was against Spain. In the middle, you've got our famous Formula One driver. And on the right, you can see ice skating again. A couple of years back, we actually somehow nailed it to win almost all the prizes on 500, 1,000 and 1,500 meters, or 5,000 meters of ice skating. And that's why sometimes the Americans tend to say that they should just skip ice skating from the Olympics, because that's the only thing the Dutch win. After there's a short video we'll play of a regional sport in the Netherlands. They only play it in the north of the Netherlands, and it's called Vuurlijpen. It's basically trying to jump over the water using a stick, and it's really funny to see. So let's take a look.
De tweede die door de 20 meter komt is Wilco van Amerongen. De benschopper leapt op een achtergroen naar 20:48. En pak de leading. Friese favoriet Tevis Hopma had een...
You can see, sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't work out. And another fun fact about that clip, they actually don't talk Dutch in that clip, but they talk in Fries, which is the language of the state Friesland. And I have no clue what they're saying. And the last guy had like the shirt with blue and white stripes and red hearts on it, and that's their local flag. Now I just want to switch to some inventions. The Dutch actually invented Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, so thanks to us, we can actually do all these online events. So no worries, it's okay. We wrote Python too. We invented gin, so you might think like, oh, London dry gin. No, it's actually the originals from Amsterdam. The first thermometer from Mercury was made in the Netherlands, as well as a telescope. The first working submarine was also made in the Netherlands. You can see it on the left bottom side. It still had like paddles and it fit like two people, but you could like navigate it. So it was pretty fun, I think. And we really like to sail on the sea. And at some point, a guy thought, yeah, we can also just make a car with that, right? Try to sail on the land. Didn't really work out, but yeah, he did try it. So that was the first land yacht that was made in the Netherlands. And we only have one car brand remaining, actually. It's called DAF in Dutch. Nowadays, it only makes trucks, but before, it also made cars. And they're famous for one thing, one really funny thing. It didn't just have one reverse gear. No, it had a gear to reverse all the gears. So you could get into sixth gear in reverse, meaning you could drive like 120 kilometers an hour in reverse. So they figured out they could race in reverse with the cars, which wasn't always too good of a plan and resulted in a lot of funny videos. So a short bit of that with actual Dutch comments this time. We'll be playing right now. Well, like you could see, it didn't really work out the way it should be working out. And on that same topic, we also had some troubles, probably all countries had last 4 years ago when Trump became president. It was with the America First thing. And one of our most famous comedians made a video of that. And some other countries kind of copied it to also make like a Spain second. And this is our version. And you can really see like some famous places and people from the Netherlands. So I'd like to show you that one too.
Nou dan, afgelopen vrijdag was het zover. De 45ste president van de Verenigde Staten werd beëdigd in Washington DC. Donald J. Trump. Hij had een duidelijke boodschap voor de rest van de wereld. Ik neuk jullie allemaal de moeder. Nou ja, hij zei het in iets andere woorden.
From this day forward, it's going to be only America first. America first.
Ja, en omdat wij ook wel inzien dat we hem beter te vriend kunnen houden, stellen wij ons landje even aan hem voor op een manier die hem wellicht het meest zal aanspreken.
This is a message from the government of the Netherlands.
Dear Mr. President, welcome to this introduction video about the Netherlands. It's gonna be a great video. It's gonna be absolutely fantastic. Our founding father was William of Orange, who fought against the Spanish, total scumbags. They fought against us for 80 years, but they couldn't beat us. Couldn't do it. Total losers. They're all dead now, by the way. We speak Dutch. It's the best language in Europe. We've got all the best words. All the other languages failed. Danish, total disaster. German is not even a real language. It's fake. It's a fake language. We've got Pony Park Slagharen, which has got to be the best pony park in the world. It's true. They're the best ponies. They are. You can ride them. You can date them. You can grab him by the pony. It's fantastic. This is the Afsluitdijk. It's a great, great wall that we built to protect us from all the water from Mexico. In fact, we built an entire ocean, okay? An entire ocean between us and Mexico. Nobody builds oceans better than we do. This ocean, it is so big, you can even see it from the moon. and we made the Mexicans pay for it. It's true. You've got the Trump Towers. We've got Lee Towers. We'd love to sing at your inauguration. Amazing. Gotta love it. We've got Maduro Dam, which is the greatest miniature town in the world. It's great. Well, it's tiny, but it's great. And the squares, they're so small, you don't even need many people to fill them. It's great. This is Gerry Eickhoff. In December, we've got this scandalous tradition of Black Pete. It's the most offensive, the most racist thing you've ever seen. You'll love it. It's great. We also have a disabled politician for you to make fun of. Her name is Jette Kleinsma. She's from the Ministry of Silly Walks. You can do a great impersonation of her. Can't wait to see it. People tell us, very important people, they tell us we've got the best tax evasion system God ever created. It's just unbelievable. You should tell your sons to put all your, their businesses here. You'll pay no taxes at all. Zero. It's ridiculous. And last but not least, we've got a great, great, great dependency on the United States. It's huge. If you screw NATO, you're gonna make our problems great again. They're gonna be huge. They're gonna be enormous. It's true. Please don't. We totally understand. It's going to be America first. But can we just say the Netherlands second? Is that okay? Thank you for watching and best wishes. We've got the best wishes in the Netherlands. They're great. It's true.
Well, there was a quick recap of some of our main sites, like the windmills and the herring again. This was my presentation. I hope you liked it. In case you need any information, in the middle of the screen, you can see really useful information, typical Dutch. And we like to say fijne avond, which is like good night in Dutch. So hereby, I would like to say good night. This was my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. And in case of any questions, just hit me up.
So thanks, Michael, for a very nice presentation about Netherlands in a nutshell. And I'm really like that even the Dutch themselves admitted that Heineken is maybe not the best beer in the world. And yeah, the last thing I just want to say is to remind you to watch the Facebook group to see all the upcoming events and other important information. And I hope we'll see each other at the last presentation of Nations next week. It will be about Sri Lanka. So have a nice rest of the evening and see you.